All right, in this video, we're going to talk about what happens after you create the invoice. All right, we've gone through all of these videos. I know how to create every single type of invoice. Now what? So now you send your invoice out to your client, and hopefully sooner rather than later, they're going to send you a payment. Okay, so once you receive that payment in the mail, you're going to go ahead in and receive payments. Okay, so we're going to receive a payment from... Again, you can don't have to do the drop down. You can start typing Abercrombie Christie, and we received payments. Okay, so first of all, if you check off this box here and it pops up, you cannot apply an amount greater than. That's because you have a preference turned on. Okay, so if you want to be able to just check, and it tells you how much, it calculates the amount for you up here, then you can do it that way. If you want that preference turned on, you go up to Preferences, Edit and Preferences, you go to Payments, then under Company Preferences, you want to say Automatically Calculate Payments. So let me show you what happens then. Okay, so now I'm going to go back here to Receive Payments, and I type in Abercrombie here. When I check, it adds it up for me. However, let's say this customer didn't pay $308.44, they paid $308.42. And so you're adding it, you're checking, and then you look at this total number up here and it's off by 2 cents. So then you have to go back through. I think it just ends up taking longer. Okay, so I'd prefer that preference be turned off. Because when you go in and you receive your payments, you know the name. You're looking at that check right there, right? And it says $1,085.44. You know how much it's for, okay? So you don't need it to, you don't need to have it automatically calculate for you. But let's say $1,085.44. So what you can do is you can come in, check, and then, so because you want to apply this, even though they're paying for this one here, you want to apply it to all the earlier invoices. Then you can go ahead and check this and apply the balance remaining after paying off those earlier invoices to this invoice that they actually paid. And then it'll leave that they still owe some money on this invoice. Or you come in here and check mark off that one, leave those as open, and they'll still sit in accounts receivable. Okay. But I do suggest putting in the total amount here. So what is... That's 240.9. Okay, so let's say the check was for $1,325.63. Okay, so QuickBooks is going to, it doesn't recognize this number, $1,325.63, so it's just going to apply it to whatever's open. But you can come in here and uncheck them and say, no, according to what the check stub says, they paid for this guy and they paid for that guy. So those two are going to be marked as paid. The other two are going to be staying in accounts receivable. Okay. And notice, too, if I try to check another one, it's going to say, wait a second, you don't have any more money to apply. So it's going to go based off of this amount up here. Once this number down here equals $1,325.63, then this amount is going to, then it's going to tell you you can't apply anymore. Okay, that's why I like that preference. It's a double check of yourself. You can choose a payment method. If you choose American Express here, notice it gives you information to fill in the card information, expiration date, all that fun stuff, and you can process it right through QuickBooks. I always recommend if you do take credit cards to you, do it right through QuickBooks. It self-reconciles. It makes your life so much easier as a bookkeeper. And, you know, you can look at all the promotions on our web store there. All right, so you can also receive it by check. Okay, so most of the time we're going to be receiving payments by check from a customer. You want to put in there the check number, any special memo. If you want to put in a memo, you can. You can change the date. So if you actually received this check last week, then you can do that. Or you were on vacation last week, so you didn't get to process any payments, so you want to post it as of last week. QuickBooks now tracks for you average days to pay, so that number does become a little bit more important for your customers. Okay. If you wanted to find a customer invoice, you could search for an invoice number in here. So if you have a ton of invoices, you could do a search for it. because you cannot filter these fields. All right, they go in order of date and then number. Okay, so here we go. We have this 1325 payment. All right, and if we had any discounts and credits on hand, we could apply those discounts and credits here. We don't have any on hand. It says that we have zero. So we're going to go ahead and say save and new. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to receive another payment from this same customer here and say save and close. So I have a couple of checks that I received, right? So now, after I receive my payments, I follow my little path down here and I go to record deposits. I click on record deposits. It's going to pop up for me all my deposits that are all my checks that I've marked as being received. So I come in here, I check off the ones that I'm going to deposit into my bank here. It does a total for me down there so I can say okay. All right, pops up here. I have another chance to review it. And I can go ahead and make sure it goes into the right bank account. The date, I can change the date. So I'm really depositing it today because I was off last week. If you are going to have any cash back, you know, you want to say, where does this cash back go against? I am taking some money out for myself as a business owner. My cash back amount is $150. So now it's going to change that deposit instead of being 4410. It's going to be 4260. Okay. I'm not going to do that for now. Okay. And then I'm going to go ahead and say save and close. So now when I go look at my checking account register, it pulls up here. I see that deposit right here. Okay. Now one of the preferences too to note is that when you receive payments, do you want to use the undeposited funds as a default deposit to account? If you uncheck this and you go to your home page and receive payments, now notice they have this extra box that we didn't have before. It says deposit to undeposited funds. So if this $3,000 went straight to the bank account, you could make a deposit straight to the bank account if you really wanted to. However, most of the time, the goal is to have several checks coming in at once, right? So you want to use that undeposited funds. And just so as not to confuse anyone, I usually prefer with my clients that we leave that feature as is. All right. So that is how you receive payments and record deposits.